Nicole Richie, welcome back. Welcome back. Thanks for being here.
Thanks so much for having me.
I've seen, like, every time you're here, we talk about your animals and that you always get, like, a new animal or something. Do you have any new animals?
Thank you so much for asking.
Yeah.
I feel like probably my most recent is my new cat, Lavender Bumblebee.
Oh, yeah. Lavender Bumblebee.
Yes.
You also have great names
for your
pets and your animals.
Yes. I know Tiger Lily Sprinkle Winks is my other cat, and she was very upset when Lavender Bumblebee came into the mix, but now they're best friends. And
Yeah. Always into animals, always into pets growing up?
I have been. You know, so when I was around 10 or 11, Paris Hilton and I used to drive to, there was a pet store on La Cienega in LA,
yeah.
And we would buy pet rats. And we just liked buying rats. We just liked doing it. And
rats were your pet of choice?
Yes, yes. Yeah, I don't know why. I actually hate rats now, so I don't know why we were into them, but we were.
How many rats did you end up having?
I had a lot, and I named them all after Beverly Hills 90210 characters, because
okay.
That was my favorite show.
Yeah, I loved it, too.
And on September 2nd, and I know this because it was my mom's birthday, Tori Spelling snuck out, and my mom woke up with Tori Spelling on her eye.
Wow.
Yes.
Was that the end of Tori Spelling?
That was the end of Tori.
You had to return Tori Spelling to the pet store.
Yes.
And say, yeah, that was the end of that.
Yes, yes, I did.
But
then
also...
I graduated on to ferrets, which we could only get in Las Vegas.
Oh.
Because they weren't legal in California, but we would drive them back. Just smuggle. So
you got into illegal pets.
Yes, no, yes,
but,
I did.
But we were talking about Prince earlier. Can you tell everyone, do you get a pet from Prince?
Yes, Prince got me my first dog. Yes. Yeah.
I mean, how do you remember this? I mean, do you remember, like, where we were?
I remember because the dog's name was God. I did not name the dog, obviously.
He wanted to call it Tori Spelling.
Yes,
but yeah,
yes.
You call it God. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, that's wild. And he just said, this is...
And he gave me the dog, yes. I was very young. I was around four. But that was my first dog.
Are you just used to seeing all these uber superstars because your dad's Lionel Richie? I mean, did you used to go to the shows? I mean, did you even go to the shows? I mean, did you...
I did go to shows, yes. But I was always backstage. And actually, the first time that I went in the audience, I remember this so clearly. One of the Pointer Sisters was there. I know, so major.
I love the Pointer Sisters.
But she had a Yorkie, and I fell in love with the Yorkie. The Yorkie had a little pink bow in its hair. And she's the one who brought me out in the audience for the first time.
Really?
Yeah.
And you were like, hey, my dad's pretty talented.
I was watching him, and I was like, I just didn't really understand the concept. I was like, why is everyone screaming and dancing? It was my first time in the audience of a real concert.
Your dad posted a video of you and your sister at one of his recent concerts.
Yes.
And
yes.
It looked like you were equally having a good time at this one as well.
Yeah.
Yeah, I want to show, here's Nicole and her sister, Sophia, at her dad's concert. That's a great daughter right there. That's a great daughter. That's what a family does.
You know, we were out there, and I gotta tell you, the ladies were loving Lionel. And
yes.
we were like, we're gonna match their
energy.
We're gonna match their energy.
Why not? Let's do it. I love Lionel too. I'll scream, Lionel! Let's talk about Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead.
Yes.
Congrats on this. It's out this Friday. I have a photo here with your whole family showed up to the premiere. Look, there's your dad, there's everybody.
Did, yeah.
Very supportive, there's your husband. Everyone just goes, yeah, they showed up, or was it planned? You go, I need everyone to be there.
I planned it in the sense of we have a family group text, so I just texted everyone and I said, you know, I said, I am having this premiere, no pressure to come. But everyone came. It was unexpected, and it was so sweet and great. My heart was full, and we had the best time.
And they just showed up, which is just so loving and such a family thing. It is a family movie, so
everyone
can relate to this. How'd you get attached to it, and you want to tell everyone what it's about?
So, Don't Tell Mom That the Babysitter's Dead originally came out in 1991. I am a diehard fan of the original. I really think that I've probably been quoting it since it came out. And I got a call that they were doing a reimagining of the film with an all-black family, and they wanted me to play Rose. And I never thought that I would play Rose, but I've always felt spiritually connected to her manic energy. So it really did feel right. And I got on a Zoom with Wade Elaine Marcus, the director, just to kind of see where he wanted to take it. And he had everything from mood boards to color palettes to music. And just after talking to him, I was so excited to do it. And we had the best time.
Yeah, it's super funny. I want to show everyone a clip. Here's Nicole Richie and Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead. Take a look.
This is the QED report. Around here, it's like the Bible, except it's full of facts. Finish these before I meet with the board biweekly. You've used Clutus before, right? Of course you have. Everyone in the industry has. IT will get you all logged in and sorted out. Oh, and the most important thing, if we're not alone, and I ask you for something, you just say, I'm right on top of that, Rose.
I'm right on top of that, Rose.
Come on. Nicole Richie, everyone. Don't Tell Mom the Babysitter's Dead is in theaters nationwide this Friday. Liam Gallagher and John Squire perform for us after the break. Stick around!